intriguing facts about billionaires. Hey everyone, it's Lexa again, and welcome back to another video. We all know a millionaire or two, but very few of us know a billionaire. That's possibly because there are only 2,209 billionaires in the world as of 2018, and there are around 36 million millionaires, a vast difference. The richest man in the world is Jeff Bezos, the CEO and president of Amazon, who is worth $139 billion. But before we get into today's video, make sure that you're subscribed and ring the bell so that you never miss any of our upcoming videos. Born this way. Many billionaires are fortunate in that they inherit their extreme wealth. However, 67% of billionaires are self-made. They worked hard to gain their fortune and didn't have the luxury of having the cash handed to them on a silver platter. Bill Gates and Mark Zuckerberg are two prime examples of self-made billionaires. Cash is king. Pablo Escobar was a Colombian drug lord, and he made his billions through all his illegal activities. Rumor has it that he needed to spend $2,500 a month on rubber bands just to keep his money together. He would write off 10% of his cash annually because of rats literally chewing through it, which he stored in a warehouse. Dropout. J.K. Rowling is the first person to fall off of Forbes billionaire list for willingly giving away vast amounts of her fortune to charity. She says, "You have a moral responsibility when you've been given far more than you need to do wise things with it and give intelligently." She's the first author to ever become a billionaire. The Big Apple. New York City is the place where you will find the highest number of billionaires living. There are 79 who call New York City home, and their combined wealth amounts to $364.6 billion. The richest billionaire in the city is Mike Bloomberg. Call him God. Did you know that God is a billionaire? His surname is Nisanov, and God Nisanov is the 527th richest person in the world. He made his wealth in property development in Russia, and he's worth $3.5 billion. It's a numbers game. Here's a crazy statistic. Take 4 billion of the poorest people in the world, and their combined income wouldn't be able to compete with the 8 richest people in the world. Give it away. Almost 100 billionaires have signed the Giving Pledge, which is a promise to give away half of their fortune over their lifetime. It's in the genes. Daniel Keith Ludwig was a billionaire who made his money through shipping. He had a feeling that his estranged ex-wife's daughter might try to challenge his will, and his hunch was correct. So, to prevent her from getting her hands on his fortune pretending that he was her birth father, he froze his DNA. When she did sue the estate after his death, the DNA analysis proved that he was not her biological father. Runs in the family. Julia Louis-Dreyfus, who played the role of Elaine in Seinfeld, inherited quite a vast sum of money when her father passed away. Many reports will tell you she inherited billions, making her one of the wealthiest women in America. But she set the record straight by saying the following, "It's unbelievable because whatever I do, people just assume it's true. She's only worth $200 million. Only." Blank check. 88-year-old Ross Perot, former presidential candidate and billionaire, once wrote a blank check and donated it towards a fund to save an ancient treaty oak in Austin, Texas. The 500-year-old oak had been poisoned by a vandal in 1989. He made his money through his company, Electronic Data Systems and Perot Systems, and is worth $4 billion today. Well hidden. The super wealthy are very good at hiding their fortune. It's estimated that roughly $7.6 trillion is being hidden in offshore accounts, which means that around 1% of the wealthiest people are evading in the region of $200 billion in taxes. Humble beginnings. Most billionaires began their careers as salespeople, stock traders, software developers, and analysts. Name it. A Kuwaiti billionaire has his fortune tied up in something unusual. Domain names. His portfolio of valuable domain names amounts to $3 billion and includes party.com and research.com. Apparently, he refuses to sell or monetize them. Some believe this to be a PR stunt, and Wiki says the most expensive domain name is lasvegas.com, which sold for $90 million in 2005. Don't call me sir. Bill Gates was knighted in 2005, however, you may not put the title Sir in front of his name due to him being American. You can put the letters KBE after his name, which stands for Knight Commander of the British Empire. Name withheld. He was once the richest man in Los Angeles. Kirk Kerkorian was president and CEO of Tresinda Corporation, a private holding company which he started. He donated more than $200 million to various schools on the condition that nothing was named in his honor. Ahead of his time, and you thought ESL was a recent concept. However, billionaire Bertil Holt first founded EF Education in 1965. This program allowed Swedish students to head to England for proper English lessons. Locals were paid a daily fee to house and feed the students, and then they had their lessons with native English speakers. The company grew rapidly, servicing 116 countries with 115 million students. Holt was labeled a horrible student and dropped out of college. Now, he's worth $4.5 billion. Spend it wisely. You'd imagine the son of Warren Buffett to have a little money sense, but I suppose anyone at the age of 19 is not quite adept at dealing with finances. When Peter, the youngest son of Warren Buffett, received $90,000 worth of stock from his dad at age 19, he spent it on recording equipment. Had he left the stock as is, it would have been worth $70 million today. Peter doesn't seem to miss it, though, and is a success in his own right as a musician, composer, author, and philanthropist. Put it on my card. Reports suggest that the largest ever purchase made on an American Express Black Card totaled $170 million. It was made by Chinese billionaire Liu Yichan. The upside to this large purchase was free first-class travel for his family for the rest of their lives. This large purchase was to buy a painting, reclining nude, at auction. Gap is growing smaller. There are more male billionaires than there are female. However, the gap is growing smaller. 2018 saw an increase of 18% in female billionaires, which exponentially outpaces the growth of billionaires as a whole. Money talks. Howard Hughes is a name that goes together with flying and Las Vegas. His father invented a two-cone roller bit for drilling, which is where his money originated from. When his parents died, he inherited 75% of the company. He convinced everyone else to sell their share of it. He then moved to Hollywood, made movies, and flew planes. His story is enough to fill several YouTube videos. He owned a great portion of Las Vegas, and one neon sign from the Silver Slipper Casino annoyed him so much, he bought the casino just so he could remove the sign. Almost, but not quite. Just recently, Kylie Jenner made headlines for being the youngest self-made billionaire, but many people were not happy. First, her net worth is around $900 million, falling shy of the billion mark by 100K. Then, a lot of her wealth was largely thanks to her family's media empire. So to say she's the youngest self-made billionaire is maybe a little inaccurate. Thrifty. He's the owner of a $200 million yacht. Pakistan billionaire Shahid Khan made his initial fortune by making car bumpers for Toyota. He is officially the richest man in Pakistan, but it wasn't always glamorous. He started off washing dishes, earning $1.20 an hour. That's inspiration right there. On top of his expensive yacht, he owns four private jets, the Jacksonville Jaguars, the soccer club Fulham FC, and is worth $7 billion. Money makes the world go round. When Augustus Caesar was the emperor of Rome, the empire was responsible for over a quarter of the world's economic output. Some believe that Caesar earned roughly 20% of what the empire made, meaning that in today's monetary value, he would have been worth an estimated $5 trillion. Go, go, Power Rangers! We can thank billionaire Haim Saban for bringing us children's shows like Power Rangers. He also wrote the theme song for the show using a pseudonym. He is the 232nd richest person in America, and he bought the Power Rangers franchise back in 2010. He sold the franchise to Hasbro in 2017 for $522 million. Hard to believe. Jean-Paul Getty was a petrol industrialist born in 1892. His grandson was J. Paul Getty III, and when he was 16, he was kidnapped. The kidnappers demanded $17 million in ransom for his release. The grandfather refused to pay the ransom and was quoted as saying, "I have 14 other grandchildren, and if I pay one penny now, then I'll have 14 kidnapped grandchildren." 5 months went by, and only after Getty received the severed ear of his grandson did he agree to pay $3 million, of which he only paid $2.2 million. J. Paul Getty III didn't have a great life thereafter and died at the age of 54 in his home near London. King of Kings. Described as being the richest man in history, African King Mansa Musa was worth $400 billion when he died in 1331. His empire extended from modern-day Ghana, Timbuktu, and Mali. Apparently, on a three-month trip to Cairo, he handed out so much gold that the value of gold plummeted, and it took Cairo a very long time to recover. His empire produced over half the world's gold and salt, with some saying that salt held a higher value than the gold. Secrets out. He was said to have quite a crazy life. Tom Perkins made his billions through Kleiner Perkins Caulfield and Byers, of which he was one of the founders. Using nautical code flags, he once spelled out a secret message on the side of his gigantic yacht. It read, "Rarely does one have the privilege of witnessing vulgar ostentation displayed upon such a scale. The boat cost $130 million to build. He was once married to author Danielle Steele, but that didn't last long." Sore loser. Donald Trump tried to sue author Timothy O'Brien for referring to him as a millionaire instead of a billionaire. O'Brien had the backing of three unnamed sources, who all confirmed that Trump was not a billionaire, and the case was dropped. Go fetch. Larry Ellison, the Oracle billionaire, is worth around $69 billion. With all that money, you can do whatever you want, including hiring someone to follow your yacht and fetch all the basketballs that go overboard, which is exactly what he did. Let the millionaires be billionaires. Forbes has just recently confirmed that Jay-Z is the first official billionaire rapper. He's also a fashionista, trendsetter, streaming music mogul, married to Beyoncé Knowles, and is the owner of a sports management company. On top of all that, he has a stake in Uber, has an enviable art collection, dabbles in real estate, and somehow finds the time to be a regular dad. Well done, Jay-Z. Keep it in the family. It's said that 88% of billionaires are married and generally have more children. The average per household is 2 children, but the average among billionaires is 4. What is the first thing you would do if you had $1 billion? Let us know in the comments below. 1. It's a sign. You're very lucky if you're born an Aquarius, because most of the billionaires featured on Forbes Top 100 share this star sign. The lead isn't big though, at 12.5%. Behind it is Taurus with 10.3%.